In my belief, the initial reason to do tea is to take somebody from their daily world and give them refuge, give them moments of just complete freedom to just relax into the moment. So you leave everything outside. And in a lot of tea rooms in Japan, they have pegs next to the entrance of the tea room where you would symbolically hang everything from the outside world. Cha is tea, do is path or way. So Chadō is the way of tea. It's the host's initial goal to make a delicious bowl of tea. And that sounds somewhat simple. It sounds like just put the tea in, add the water and whisk. However, there's history behind that. There's legacy behind that. And as you study tea, the path of tea, you realize it's not only that bowl of tea. And so to complete making that delicious bowl of tea, you're carrying a whole tradition into the tea room with you. To help understand what Chadō is, you have to experience it. We sort of live in a crazy world right now, a very busy world. I know people who are just the most calm people, but periodically their lives are crazy. Tea was originally followed to give people moments of tranquility, no matter how small they are. The full tea ceremony is 4 hours long. And in that time, you really get that sense of being isolated from the rest of the world and a time to be quiet, to be calm, and not feel guilty about it, to be experiencing it and enjoying it. For a guest, it's having a sweet and a bowl of tea. For the host, it's making that bowl of tea. Serving the sweets, of course, making the tea. The kimono are usually a little softer in appearance, but there's many layers on underneath. And I have my fan. Usually a fan is the symbol of a guest, right? Whereas the symbol of a host, somebody coming in to make tea, is a cloth, a silken cloth that you wear. What the ultimate goal is, the outside world doesn't exist, that you are in this world and you are only present. You forget the shopping list. You forget dinner. You forget what you did this morning. You just become present.